high COE prices, yearly inspections, and the LTA breathing down your neck if you even attempt to slightly bend the rules. There are many reasons to dampen your spirits if you're a car or a vehicle enthusiast in Singapore. Now, I know what you're thinking, and I want you to hold that thought. Welcome to the Season 2 special episode of Clutched. And today, we are going to have a look at this tiny little group called Blacklist. Okay, for those of you guys who have actually no clue, right? Blacklist is so big that it's actually broken down into different divisions based on East, West, Central and North. And whom I have with me right now is actually the East Side Coordinator. We have Mr. Jack.
Hi, I'm Jack. We have three coordinators in East Side. Mr. Linden.
Hi,
Mr. Adam. And we have our own mummy that is helping us to organize.
Right, so is her name mummy or what? Because you call her, you call her mummy,
yeah, she's known as for mummy.
Oh, because she has the motherly love, I suppose. Alright. How would you say Blacklist is different from other groups?
What is different that we encounter is that Blacklist is really very much family oriented. So basically, we've seen people from very much older, as well as even kids joining us as well.
What do you guys do usually in a group in Blacklist? How about you, Adam?
We normally do meet up, car wash. After you go to meet for have a drink or eat, makan, everything.
Things that you would do in a family. And since we're talking about family, let's go to the mummy. Mummy, what would you say is one of the biggest drawbacks for vehicle enthusiasts in Singapore?
The biggest challenge would probably be, each individual by itself. It's how each people actually respect one another. Blacklist actually consists of all kind of models, not only a certain brand. So one of the particular speciality that Blacklist has is not focusing on a particular group. Everybody sharing the same passion.
Ah, you see, she has said the key word over here, passion. What would it take for someone to join you guys, and how can they go about doing so, Jack?
Okay, anybody can join Blacklist, regardless of. Like what I said just now, regardless of vehicles, whether you have it, you own it or not, regardless of race, religion or language. So you can join it in the Facebook, and our admin Sherwin and Jason will approve for you to join in our Facebook.
So anybody can join?
Anybody.
Any vehicle?
Any vehicle.
What if it's not a LTA registered vehicle?
Well, if you feel that you have the passion, you can join.
Actually, that was a trick question.
It's okay.
So thank you guys. Thank you. All right. Alright guys, right now we are with yet another Blacklist member, Mr. Wei Chie. Wei Chie, you want to tell us a little bit more about yourself and what your ride is about?
I'm driving a Daihatsu Coupon.
Have you done any modifications to it?
No, not yet.
Not yet. The key word here is yet. Okay, because after this, he's going to totally modify the car, am I right?
Yeah.
Well, I'm right. Wow, okay, interesting. If I gave you $1 million, okay, $1 million, tell me, what car would you buy and why?
Mazda RX-7.
Wow, okay. Very, very good choice. Why?
It's my dream car actually. The outlook is nice and it's fast.
Short, sharp and sweet. Thank you, Mr. Wei Chie! Right now, we are actually with the bike group coordinator. So Barry, to start off, tell us a little bit more, or maybe in one line, tell us about what Blacklist is all about.
For our bike group, right, it's actually a community where all riders will have that have passion in bikes to actually gather together. We don't care about the power of your ride or what type of ride you have. Let me introduce. This is Regine. She's a daily road wind rider and Reginald.
There are rumors going around, people saying that Blacklist is actually a group consisting of people with illegal modifications simply because of the name Blacklist, okay? So what do you think, or what do you have to say, what do you guys have to say about this?
I feel that people shouldn't be so mainstream just by the word. So maybe people can actually join us and have the fun, so everyone knows that this group is actually for passion and instead of just illegal modification.
Everyone's thinking in this group is actually the same. It's just for passion, and actually it's not for racing or ego-wise.
What would a person need to actually come on board and join your group of Blacklist bikers?
They need to have a very strong passion.
How do you gauge whether or not their passion is strong?
The way they maintain it and how they actually ride with their bike, you can see.
What would you say if I told you that was a trick question? Okay, he's lost. Cut. Guys, right now we are with yet another admin of the Blacklist group. Introducing Acha!
Hi guys, my name is Achap. I'm representing my team Namaiki Tora, which is established in 2007. We got trucks, we got bikes, we got cars, almost everything lah, because we are one big happy family like all those other people who play rides, you know, all those custom rides.
I think they are trying to tell you enough, you know, that's why they keep clapping their hands. In one line, tell me what Blacklist is all about.
It's about family.
Wow. Can you give me a rough estimate of roughly how much you would have spent doing this whole truck up?
3.5k.
If I could take away your truck now and give you a completely stock truck and give you $3,500 cash, would you do it all over again?
I'd be happy to do it again, because every new trucks come to me, I have to be creative, make a new idea. So yeah, I'll be happy to do it again.
How about a big round of applause, your supporters? Yes. Let's have a warm welcome for Mr. Tommy Hilfiger. No Hilfiger. Mr. Tommy Disfiger.
This is a Suzuki Swiss Sport. I've been driving for about 3 years with a slight modification, which is legal. Okay.
You notice how everybody is very quick to actually mention that it's legal. Are you sure it's legal? No.
Maybe like 20k.
As in 20,000.
Yeah.
Did you say it's legal?
Yeah.
Bro, can you help me call LTA now? Would you do it all over again?
No, I wouldn't.
No?
Yes.
Okay, interesting. Why?
Because this 20,000 cash, I can upgrade to a higher level. Car, I mean.
Have you heard of clutched?
Yes.
You have?
Yeah. Clutch is basically doing some interviews for those different type of cars, and then having it on YouTube to share with everyone out there.
Good. Do you like the channel?
So
most important question, do you like it, yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, he's given the right answer. You escape.
So I get a prize for that?
Yeah, your prize is waiting in the next car park. You just take a walk over there, you will see your prize coming to you. Thank you, Mr. Tommy. Lucifer, dawn of the morning, I'm gonna chase you out of earth. Lucifer, dawn of the morning. Lucifer, dawn of the morning, I'm gonna chase you out of earth. Lucifer, dawn of the morning. Lucifer, Right now, we have two very proud owners of a car which we have actually reviewed before. It's none other than the Mitsubishi Lancer GLX, otherwise known as the CS3. Let's give it up for Farhan and Shikin!
Okay, basically the colour is called Battleship Grey. And then the modification all legal one. Definitely legal lah.
How do you feel about your husband spending so much on his car? Okay. Are you jealous?
No. Because I will support him whatever he like. Because whatever I want, he will also buy for me.
Brother, you have found the perfect formula to make the car and the girlfriend wife happy. Wow, congratulations, brother. Killing two birds.
$1 million. Definitely the GTR lah.
Yes, the Nissan GTR 35. Okay, that's a good answer. That's a good answer. But I want to know why.
Exotic car, powerful car, and it's Japanese. I support Japanese car.
Fan, do you have Japanese blood running in you?
No.
Do you eat sushi for breakfast, lunch, and dinner? No. Then. As in Ken Block, Ken.
Yeah, they call me Kena Block.
There are some cars over here that have caught my eye, but this is a car which has caught my heart.
Okay, this is a Nissan 200SX. Some call it Nissan S13. And it's manufactured in 1989. Yeah, so it's a very old car.
I have seen old cars, okay, and this doesn't look anything like an old car.
Okay, I'm running the Singapore Motorsport Academy. And we teach gymkhana and drifting. Wow. Yeah. So actually, I got this car to teach.
You heard that from Ken, who's actually a new owner of this S13. Thank you very much, Ken, and of course, Singapore Motorsports Academy. Yeah, we will be hearing more of them very soon. What is a car meetup if you don't have JDM?
Nothing, I just buy a stock car. Everything is stock.
Is that the safe answer you're trying to give me?
Yeah. I only change the rims and I change the sunroof. 1989.
It's an 89 CRX and this would be the first generation CRX?
No, I think second generation.
Second generation CRX, okay. So it's actually a very, very famous JDM car, right? Which many people actually know about. Have you heard of Clutched?
Yeah.
Oh, is it? Oh, wow, yeah, wow! You can give me your honest opinion, do it,
yeah. Because I know more about cars, Because you all feature a lot of cars.
Okay. Yeah. Looks like Clutch is going to be taken over by our new host, Mr. Irvin. Here, take over the mic, and then I'll... How do you think we can improve? How do you think we can change?
I think it's okay, because everything is... What the car has feature is already, you all already say.
Oh, as in, it's the basic stuff, lah. Yeah. Of course, because the brainchild of Clutch is of course not as clever, does not have enough experience as Mr. Alvin over here, whom I believe is a very, very experienced man. Thank you, Mr. Alvin, and good luck with your CRX. Thank you. We have another one of the Blacklist admin guys. He's Mr. Rexton and he's in charge of Central Division, right?
Yeah.
Central Division, oh my god, I sound like this. This sounds like some Singapore police force.
Well, for me, my role will be passing down information, also to coordinate and also to as well as get all the members together so as to get to know each other. The biggest challenge they will face will be, well, I say sometimes people have different views, so it will take quite a while for them to accept each other, that kind of thing.
What do you want to say to people who are slamming Blacklist for whatever the reason?
Well, I would say that when you are successful, you will have haters. So, no matter what they say, we will still continue to grow, we will still stay united because of the word passion.
See, he's using the keyword again. Thank you so much, Rexton. Alright guys, right here, right now, we are with yet another Blacklist member, Mr. Donovan. Tell us about yourself and your sexy little ride that you have right here.
I'm Donovan. I'm currently driving a Toyota MRS. My car is actually battery stock.
And how long have you been driving this car?
Around 5 years.
You own two MRS? Wow, so two of the same cars?
MRS was a SMT.
Okay.
Then from there, then I sell it away.
Okay. Okay.
Then from there, then I buy another MRS, which is actually manual transmission. It will definitely be a normal MC.
Wow.
I can say that it's a supercar killer. It can easily outbeat a few Lamborghinis and also Ferraris.
Let me tell you guys. This guy knows his car stuff.
Invest on your handling, such as brakes, etc. And also very good tires. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, what Donovan has just mentioned is actually a very, very important point. And if you actually watched the first episode of Season 2 in Clutch, when we covered the WRX, this is exactly something that I actually said. All right, power is not everything, all right? It's important, but there's so much more to a car than just power. Have you ever heard of Clutched?
No, but...
Okay, cut the light, cut the camera. No, he's not heard of Clutch. This interview will not be aired. Okay, no, I'm just kidding. Thank you very much, Donovan, with his MRS. Thank you. Live your life to express, not to impress. I think one of the things that we have learned today is that the car or the vehicle that you actually have, vehicle that you actually drive, it actually says a lot about you. One big difference between what we saw today and all the other car shows that you get out there, yes, there's no trophies, there's no prizes, there's no entrance fee, there's no transactions involved, there's no race queens, which is something that has been bothering me for a long time. Every time you go to a car show, there are tons of race queens. I do love them, but that also means that you get, you know, a crowd of I don't know, horny photographers who are just waiting for an upskirt shot. I don't know, all right? Okay, no offense to the real photographers out there, but over here you get none of that. So what you have is just pure people with their rides and expressing in their various art forms what they love. This officially marks the end of Season 2 of Clutched. And I am so excited about Season 3 because it's going to be a whole new change. There's going to be a whole new format. We're going to have more faces. We're going to have so many people involved. There's going to be... Okay, you know what? I'm not going to spoil it for you. But I'll tell you this. If you don't want to miss out on an amazing new season, subscribe to Clutched.